breath in. We're going to slowly lift the head, the shoulders, extending the spine, gently walking the torso up, still looking at that extended foot. Head lifting up tall. Slowly unwind, breathe, maybe a little bit towards the other side, just a gentle counter twist, and back, center, breathe, and then slowly begin to bend that extended leg, gently moving it side to side, notice how the hip feels. Bending both feet equally, gently windshield wiper. Slowly at the same time, lifting the torso, bringing the ribs up towards them. And back up, lifting up, reaching up, bring the knees together, give them a squeeze, a gentle tug. Maybe forehead to the knee. Maybe. And inhale, lift up. Come into a sort of a very, very casual bound angle. You know, you don't have to have feet together, just maybe on each other. And we're going to gently, slowly start to interlace the fingers into your toes. And then while it's here, we're just going to bring the knee up and down. All right, we're just holding the foot, giving it a handshake, if you will. Shaking the foot back and forth all the way around, working on the ankle joint, working on the toes, the foot. And then really opening up those toes. Really get them open, pull on them gently, and then maybe move them back and forth. So very therapeutic today. And relax, shake it out. We're gonna go to the other foot, another hip. Same idea. If available, interlacing your fingers and your toes. And gently lifting, opening up here. Now we're gonna move the knee up and down. You should feel a little bit of movement in the hip here, or a lot. Just be mindful of any hip issues. And again, we're going to just work on the ankle, rotating it around. And forward and back. Shake it out. And then try and open it up a little bit more between those toes. And pull on the toes. Really pulling the knuckles apart, the joints and the toes. Gently moving just the toes back and forth, side to side. And relax. Deep breaths in. Good. We're going to come onto our knees. We're going to come into a child's pose. We'll be here for a couple of minutes. You're welcome to add cushion to the knees. You're welcome to make an adjustment if child's pose isn't for you today. You're welcome to use bolsters. Initially, I'm going to have you curl your toes under to continue working the toes. And just gently open up the toes, extending the arms, and then pressing back. Again, you're welcome to use blocks, props, wherever you need them, for your hips, for your forehead, if they don't touch the heels or floor. We'll just spend about 10 seconds on our toes,
And then after a few breaths, or about 10 seconds, then just extend the toes. You're welcome to move the hips initially. Feeling the movement from one pinky to the other pinky. When you're ready, extending the toes, uncurling them, and pressing back deeply into your child's pose. Really feel the extension through the spine. Think of the sacrum pressing down. Think of the vertebrae in the lower lumbar opening up, up through the waist, the vertebrae along the ribs, the thoracic spine. Notice the shoulder blades laying right alongside the spine, up through the shoulders. Now the neck or cervical spine. Nice long spine. Notice tension or youth in your body, maybe along the ankles, maybe the knees, maybe the shoulders. Make adjustments as you need to. For the knees, you're welcome to place items underneath for cushioning, behind the knee to reduce the angle and therefore pressure. You're welcome to use a prop under the ankles to reduce the extension along the ankle, if that is an issue. Slowly breathe in and out. Breath in and slowly come up onto your knees into tabletop. We're coming into a prone position onto our bellies. And we're going to today attempt starfish. So this is a deep shoulder stretch. Any issues with shoulder today, don't worry about it. You can just gently keep the arms open into a T and not worry about rolling the body. So what we do is we come over to the right side of our mat. And we're going to be stretching the left shoulder. So arms are extended. You're welcome to watch initially if you'd like to see what is going on. And the arms extend out. All right, see if you can relax them, but make sure they're about a 90 degree from the body. And then we're going to slowly bring the right hand, bending the elbow, right next to your chest. And then I'm going to push that right hand to the floor, lifting the right shoulder, and slowly just turning, relaxing the head to the floor. All right, and you're going to be stretching this section, especially underneath on the floor. And we're going to start to lift the right shoulder and stretch this left shoulder. You're welcome to bend the knees. And you can stay at whatever spot. So this is enough for you. just a little bit, or if you want to go deeper, or even deeper, bending knees, then maybe a foot for support, maybe the hand will come up and add the weight for the twist. And you can go even deeper, but I think this is pretty much where I'll go with you today. Slowly taking your time. I'll come around and see if anyone needs help. Or if anyone has questions. Again, this is deep shoulder stretch. Do what you can do, or don't bother doing it. If you want to do Shavasana, that's all right. How's the shoulder? Do you want to go deeper? Alright, so bend the other knee, the lower leg, and bring it up to knee. You feel that? Oh yeah. You can then this hand might attempt to reach the other hand. You're almost there. Yeah. There. You can stay right there. You can come out of it. Some people might even twist the knees all the way around. Some people. Some people.
Mary.
What a good day. On another hot day. I was just laughing at the expression on your face a couple of seconds ago when she twisted you.
That was an expression of joy.
Glory. Accomplishments.
How marvelous.
Relax the head. Sleep through it.
Breathe. Remember not to hold the breath. I can try and take nice deep breaths, deeper exhales. Nice slow exhales. Feeling numbness, you're welcome to come out of this. Deep breath in, slowly begin to unwind from wherever you're at. Start bringing the arm back down in front of you if it isn't already there. The knees forward, begin to extend the legs if they're bent, begin to drop the chest to the floor completely, keeping the arm, the left arm extended, extend the right arm into a T, allow the hands to drop down, palms up, combine the hips, try and release that left shoulder. Gently breathe, moving the head side to side. Bring the arms up ahead in front of you like Superman. And extend, reach. Bring both hands under the shoulders and slide yourself now to the left side of your mat. Same thing on this side. Right arm will be out in a T. Again, each side can be very different, so take your time, listen and assess. Bring the left hand right next to your chest and shoulder, elbows are up, and slowly begin to press the left shoulder up. Feel the right shoulder start to feel the pressure. Welcome to bend your knees whenever you're ready. Again, stay
right where you're at, if that's where you need to be. If you wish to go further, begin by just bending the upper knee and pressing that left foot to the floor, maybe bringing the left hand to the hip or behind the back. Relax the face. Notice any numbness you may be feeling. Be present so you can relax the head, relax the neck, and release that tension. And then slowly, we're going to start to unwind, starting with the legs, releasing the hand if it's behind you. Take it very slowly. Use your breath to guide you out of this. This is one of the deeper poses I'll ever put you into. You're welcome. When you're ready, coming into a prone position. Yes, relax the shoulders onto your belly. Shoulders relaxed, arms come out into a T. Slowly down towards the hips. Bring the palms up, allowing the shoulders to relax completely. Gently move the head side to side, releasing any tension in the neck. When you're ready, you're going to come into a short child's pose, pressing back, extending through the spine, realigning the spine. That was that could have been a deep twist for you. So realign the spine, really extend, open up, breathe. Now a full child's pose, bringing hands down by the feet. Maybe grab the feet and pull yourself a little bit closer. And keep the hands down by the feet, palms up. Notice the shoulders are heavy. The forehead firmly into the floor prop. Gently guide the hands back up. We're coming into a supine position onto our backs for Shavasana. If there is a pose you wish to do, this is the time to do it. Otherwise, get yourself as comfortable as you can for our Shavasana. Again, your legs can be propped, even in bound ankle if you prefer. The arms to be down by the side, and palms up, shoulders relax completely. Focus on your breath, slowly in and out through the nose. Notice the lift of the chest with the inhale, coming back to your three-part breathing, focusing on the quality of air. Focusing on the efficiency of your breath. Noticing what the tension is being held. Starting with the feet, relaxing the toes, the arches, the ankles, even the shins. Relaxing both muscles of the calf. Relaxing the knees, the hamstrings, and the quadriceps. Relax the hips, the glutes, even the pelvic floor. Notice the fingers heavy, completely surrendered to the floor. The wrists, upper arm, the shoulder, the neck, the face, begin to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, gently move the head side to side,
Bend the knees.
And slowly move the knees side to side. Taking your time, rolling over onto one side. And when you're ready, coming up into a comfortable seated position. Inhale, arms come up, reach up. Extend through the fingers, palms together, and come into prayer. Thank you for being here, totally in mind and body, accepting where they are, leaving all the chaos, the ego, all the worries outside of this room, allowing this to be your hour, maybe a little silence within. Strengthening, finding courage as we step out. May that light in you always seek the peace, always seek the good. The light in me sees and honors that light. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you and have a good day.
Thank you.